episode one of my Let's Play. This is my first time ever having ever playing modded Minecraft. So I've been playing for a few days, and I know a few things about the mods I have installed. I don't know everything fully yet, so I guess that's pretty much what we're gonna be learning together. I'm definitely excited for this. You guys are too. We have some of the more popular mods that you most likely seen a lot, and then a few mods that I just kind of liked. I mean, this isn't a mod pack, it's just kind of a mix of mods that I really liked and found that looked fun over the years watching YouTubers, so these mods I installed. So we're kind of doing that. But I think this starter episode, we're just going to kind of just explore a little, try to figure out a base location. I also have a journey map installed, because it's so much better than the vanilla map. Way easier. I can even see mobs on it, so peaceful. And I'm still learning keyboard and mouse in these mods, so pretty much first modded Let's Play, we're kind of learning together. One thing I would like to point out really quickly, loading the chunks might be a little bit laggy. So if that happens when we're loading new chunks, I am sorry for that. You can kind of see it now. So I'm very sorry about any lag when we're loading chunks. And we got very lucky with the hero's bow. We don't have arrows. Basic enchants though. For those of you guys that don't know what lucky blocks are or chance cubes, lucky blocks and chance cubes are, it's basically a block that gives you random items. It can be anything good to diamonds, an ender dragon egg if you're lucky, or something very bad like TNT or something that'll kill you. And then chance cubes are basically a super enhanced version of lucky blocks, and they're very dangerous. They can literally replace your inventory. They can spawn a bunch of TNT. It's basically exciting, but you'll see as we get into it. I'm not gonna try to explain everything. And the reason we don't want to fight this boss right away is because some of these bosses, depending on like the rarity, have over 100 health, and starting out it's not gonna be useful. I mean, you're probably gonna die a lot. Boss has 120 health. And I'm already dead. It's so laggy. Oh my gosh. I didn't want to try to fight him, but I need to get my stuff. Of course, it had to be a skeleton. If it was zombie, it'd be fine. So I'm sorry about that. Okay, my aim is horrible. Can you not move? Okay. Scare baby villager. Why is it so laggy when I die? This is also why I don't want to fight these bosses. Depending on the boss, I do like 1 and 2 damage, and if they're like over 100 health, I mean, it's very annoying. So we're probably going to try to get a backpack between the first two episodes. I want to say that's all the villagers. Yeah. These sarcastic probably need to save, but we need the health. So gonna. Well, everything loads.
Oh.
This is awkward. I just tried to make bread with hay bales. Because that's totally possible. Ah. Totally possible. Is my inventory gonna sort? There we go. Actually, you know, I should steal a bed. I should steal a bed. And we got our first chance cube. And chests are also gonna be super useful. You can toss that out, I guess. Tomato seeds will probably be useful. That are offhand. This. Place that down real quick. Cause I wanna get this chance cube down. Okay, we got a firefox. Okay, I'm just gonna cut back and just so you guys don't have to suffer through all these laggy chunks being loaded. I will come right back, whatever. I'm gonna cut here. So I can see. Oh no. Oh no. Okay. I kinda know why it's happening. I mean, it's a mix of like all the mods I have installed, plus OBS. And it's all running on the processor because I don't have like extra RAM or like a graphics card to help offload the weight. So it's all running on the same thing. So it's very laggy. But that's okay. I mean, I just deleted two gold blocks. Okay. Yeah. The weird thing is though, once the chunks are loaded, everything seems to be working, it's not as laggy. Once chunks are loaded, it's not as laggy, but when we're trying to load chunks, it gets super, super laggy. Visibility and a bunch of particles. That's useful. Okay, I don't know how good these enchantments are. That's really good, actually. God dang it. Hold up. I hate you. You know I hate you. There you go. Wait, do I have leather? Oh, I hope I have leather. I have leather. Cool. Okay. No cuts then. That we could do. This quickly, quickly, quickly. quickly. Can I? I need to. Why are you? Why is? Yay, we got our backpack. Okay. Oh my. Big milestones. Big milestones right here. Big milestone. Wow, our backpack is pretty much used up already. Are you not gonna? There we go. Now we can access our backpack at any time. This was basically why we wanted the backpack. That cake is probably just gonna be left behind, by the way. I don't know if we'll use it. More lag. We love the lag. Cool, let's look at these enchants now. Ooh, sorry about that. Let's look at these enchants now. So we got blast protection, mid. Piercing, multiple enemies, mid. Looting 3, that's good. Knockback 2, mid. Fortune 1, it could be good. Efficiency 4, that's good. Quick charge, Respiration, Respiration 3, Riptide. Honestly, very bad. Very bad enchants. Could have been better. That's fine. Dead bushes, just get a seed. We can take that, I guess. Take this. Tool breaks 3x2. Iron effectiveness against all blocks. Let me break this. Another bow. Another hero of the bow. Okay. We'll be back whenever we get to the base. Or not get to, I'll just be back whenever we get the base built. I'm glad I was recording, because... Yeah. I just got another star. Nether stars are really good. The activation range, which you see is 16. That means that a player has to be within 16 blocks of the spawner for it to be able to activate and turn on. And the spawn range is how many blocks it can spawn. So like if the spawner was here, it can only spawn like 1, 2, 3, 4 blocks away from the spawner. From like the spawner being the center. Which the nether star means that as long as the chunk is loaded where the spawner is, then basically there's no play range. So as long as the chunk is loaded, I can be 100 blocks away from the spawner and it'll still spawn the mobs. Which is very broken. And very useful for whenever we start building more spawners. Basically, nether star equals good. Once we get into mob spawners, I'll explain it more. Anyways, we'll be back for the last time. Whenever we make a base. I don't know if you guys seen it while I was showing you stuff, but I ended up making crates. And crates are really good, because this is how much storage you have. And also, you can kind of see my inventory's clean. This is why. So this is how much storage a crate has, and you can put stuff in it, but then here's the nice part about the crates, is that you can break it, and it keeps its inventory. Alright, so I kind of think I figured out where I want to build my base. It's not a bad location near us. I mean, we're next to a couple of lava pools. We're still close to water, close to trees. We got another. Oh, wait, no, that wasn't a dungeon, actually. There's this dungeon just close by. I think I'm just gonna make my base right here where these chickens are. There really wasn't much for, like, flat, super flat areas or, like, cool caves to live in. So I think we'll just kind of make something over here somewhere. Let's go ahead and make it here. Man, this area is a little bit of lag. That's fine. Okay. We'll be right back once the base is built. quick, I forgot to film the outro for the video before I close out of the world, so I'm just putting up a picture of one of the caves I found while exploring. If you guys did enjoy the video, feel free to like and subscribe. If you don't want to subscribe, that's alright. But if you do want to keep watching the series, then feel free to just tune in once so often, find a new video. Next episode, we'll probably start getting into the mods more and doing more base stuff, maybe. Off camera, I'll probably go mining a little bit, try to keep the boring stuff out of the video. If anything interesting happens, I'll make sure to put it up on the screen. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next one.